Hello everyone, Patrick LeBlanc, Principal Program Manager, Microsoft Fabric. In this video, Miguel explains and demonstrates how Translytical task flows are revolutionizing Power BI. With the ability to trigger actions and write back directly within your reports, you can update data, run workflows, and customize reports in real time. Enhance your data exploration and decision making. Let's take a look.
In this release, we are pleased to introduce Translytical Task Flows, a groundbreaking feature designed to expedite insights into actions within Power BI. Let me show you how the Translytical Task Flows feature works. This report lists all open, lost, and won opportunities. My focus is on the open opportunities, as winning these deals is crucial for growing revenue. Let's select the high-risk opportunities closing in 70 days. And set the quantity to 9. We can then assign a 25% discount to these open opportunities to increase the chances of winning the deals. After submitting, the application will update these opportunities in the Power BI report in real time. The discount is now updated to 25% in the Power BI report for all entries. By pressing submit, I used Translytical Task Flows to create a user data function in Fabric with Python code. Let's go and see this Python code. This function updated the Power BI table in real time. This Python code within the user data function updates the SQL DB following a successful submission in Power BI. I can execute a query to confirm that the data function submission has modified the discount. Now, let's go back to the Power BI report to link the action to automate the button to the scenario. In edit mode, you can select the button and configure its setup in the format settings under the action section. The type dropdown includes a new data function option, which when selected, displays three dropdowns to define the workspace, function set, and data function. Once the data function is selected, it will show all the detected parameters that our Python code needs to fulfill to trigger the function. Each parameter must be linked with either a data field or a slicer input. To link the parameter with a data field or measure, simply click on the FX button to open a dialog that allows selection. This is useful for passing an input value to the parameter when clicking on a data visualization point or cell in a table. To link the parameter with a new slicer, expand the dropdown and select one of the available new slicers detected on the page. This is useful for designing form-like experiences or for passing filter values as input values for the parameter. Only new slicers are permitted to serve as parameters, by the way. The report creator must link every parameter with either a data field or new slicer. As the button can only trigger or function once each parameter has a valid input value. To enhance our user experience, report creators can define the style of buttons in their disabled state, which occurs when parameters lack input values, or during the loading state, when the button is processing the function. The style of the button icon, fill color, border, and other elements can be adjusted. To summarize, this example has demonstrated the new functionality of buttons to automate actions, specifically how to update records. Additionally, records can be added or deleted, and it is possible to call any external API if there is a Python library available for it. This feature is currently in preview and must be activated in the Power BI Options dialog. We are thrilled to see how you use this feature to create actionable experiences directly in Power BI. We would love to hear your feedback and insights, so please share them with our team.
Wow, what a great demo. If you have any questions, comments, or you'd like to see more demos, you know what to do. Post it in the comments below. If this is your first time visiting the Power BI YouTube channel, be sure to hit that subscribe button. If you like this video, a big thumbs up. And as always, for Microsoft and myself, thanks for watching. See you in the next video.